Hello dear friends, myself Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi, and in this video we shall be discussing a very important topic of your course, lines and angles. So first of all, when it comes to line, so we know that if we join two distinct points lying on the plane anywhere, if two points are lying and when we join them, then what do we find? We find a line segment. A line segment. For example, these two points A and B are there on the plane, and distance between them is 5 centimeter. Distance between them is 5 centimeter. And how do we measure this distance 5 centimeter? We used to join A and B with the help of a scale, and scale should be straight, not should be like this. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. Join these two points using a straight scale, and then it is called distance between two points. Distance between two points means minimum distance between the points, least distance between the points. It means if two points are lying on plane, and if we join them through the least distance, then on joining through that least distance, we form a line. For example, this A and B. A and B are two points, and on joining them, we find a line segment. And sometimes line segment is denoted as this symbol. And suppose if it is a ray, then this is denoted by this symbol. And if it is a line, because line segment has its fixed distance, but a line has no distance because its distance is infinite. So line is having infinite distance, and it is denoted by this, means from both the ends it can be expanded. Ray says that it can be expanded in this direction, means suppose if it is a ray, then it can be expanded in this direction. In this direction it can be expanded, in the reverse side it cannot be expanded. But these symbols are of not much importance in your course, so we shall not be discussing more on this issue. Let's go ahead now. So what is an angle now? After discussing line, let's come to angle. What is an angle? So angle shape, you can see this is an angle, this is an angle. So it is a ray, it is another ray, but they are originated from a point, from a common point. So it means if two rays originate from a common point, from a common end point, then an angle is formed. Then an angle is formed. And suppose there is a point, let this point be B, let this point be C, and sometimes we say that union of these two rays is called an angle. And this part of angle means the whole part, this part is called interior of the angle. And naturally, it is very clear to you and very obvious that this part is called interior and this part of plane is called the whole part. This whole part is called interior because the ray can be extended in this way. So this is called interior and this part is called exterior. And these two, this ray and this ray, are called arms. Arms, this and this, both are called arms. And whenever it comes to measure an angle, how do we measure? So to measure an angle, we use a unit. That unit is called degree. And that is why protractor is also known as degree. So to measure an angle, we use protractor, which is also known as D, So to measure an angle, we use a unit. That unit is called degree. For example, if I wish to make an angle of 30 degree, so I keep protractor like this, center at this, and protractor will be like this. And if I wish to measure 30 degree, then this angle is 30 degree. Here somewhere I will find 30 degree. And if I wish to make 60 degree, so above this 30 degree, we shall have 60 degree. And similarly, from this side, even from this side we can measure. Even from this side, if I wish to measure 30 degree from this, but conventionally, because most of the people are righty, they use their right hand, most of the people. That is why the consent, it is a convention. Whenever I say that make an angle of 45 degree, what do? We draw like this, 45 degree. We do not draw like this. Even this is 45 degree, no doubt. But conventionally, we do like this. 45 degree, this is 45 degree. 60 degree, if I say 60 degree. Okay, and 90 degree, this is 90 degree. So in this way, we draw an angle. So now it is very much clear to us that what is a line, what is an angle, interior and exterior, what are rays and what are arms. This point is called origination, origin, or you can say sometimes it as end point. Okay, now let's come to more definitions related to angles. Adjacent angles. What are adjacent angles? So adjacent angle are the, first of all see the figure, then you will come to know what are adjacent angles. Let this point be A. This ray AB, this ray AC, and this D. These two angles are adjacent. Suppose it is X degree and it is Y degree. X degree and Y degree are adjacent angle. Why they are adjacent angles? Because they have common endpoint and one arm in between them must be common. This arm is common in these two, therefore these two angles are adjacent angles. If I draw this, means who are adjacent? Adjacent angles. For adjacent angles, what should be there? Common endpoint. Common endpoint. You can note whatever I am telling you, you may note in an abbreviated form in your diary or in your notebook. Common endpoint, and one arm should be common. One arm should be common. One arm should be common. If these two things are there, then such angles are called adjacent angles. And if I say this, Z degree, can I say Y degree and Z degree are adjacent? No, they are not adjacent. So who are adjacents? X degree, Y degree are adjacents. These angles are called adjacent angles, and these two, Y degree and Z degree, are not. Y degree and Z degree are not. They are not adjacent angles. And what about X degree and Z degree? They are. So X degree, Y degree adjacent, and X degree, Z degree are adjacent. Even you can say Z degree, X degree, no issue. So this was all about adjacent angles. Let's come to few more definitions and few more concepts. So I hope many things about angles will be clear to you, like what is an acute angle. Acute angle, this kind of angle is called acute angle, whose measurement, let this be theta. So what should be theta? If theta is greater than 0 degree but less than 90 degree, then angle is called what? Then angle is called acute angle. Okay, and its figure will be like this. If theta is 90 degree, then angle is called right angle. Its figure will be like this, right angle. This or this or this or this, 90 degree, right angle. Acute will be like this or will be this. But let's discuss this only. And if theta is more than 90 degree, theta is more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree, like this. Okay, so this kind of angle is called obtuse angle. What kind of angle is this? Obtuse angle. And if you wish to make this kind of figure and measure angle in this way, then this is obtuse. And similarly here, it was not convincing to me that this should not be written. So that is why I am writing here. Even this is called acute. This is acute, acute. Here, obtuse, obtuse. And if angle means arms are like this. Suppose this point is A and this point is B. Ray AB is going towards that side. Ray AC is going towards this side. Then this angle is called straight angle. And this angle's value is 180 degree. And what kind of angle is this? Straight. Straight angle. This angle is called straight angle. Let's discuss more. If this is 40 degree, then this will be what? Because it is 90 degree, 90 degree, and usually for 90 degree we use this kind of symbol. For example, if these two arms are making 90 degree angle, then we put a symbol like this here. But here we don't use this kind of symbol. You can see here. Here we use a curve, but here we use two straight lines. And even those straight lines are making 90 degree angle like this. So this is what? This is, if this is 40 degree, then I know that this is 90 degree. Therefore, this should be what? This should be 50 degree. So these two angles are called complementary angle. Complementary angles. What kind of angles are they? They are complementary angles. Okay. And if they are like this, suppose this is 45 degree, then this will be what? So straight angle is of 180 degree, and if it is 45 degree, therefore this will be 180 degree minus 45 degree. So what kind of this pair is? So this pair is called linear angles pair. Linear angles pair. Complementary angles pair. Okay. And one more thing which I did not discuss with you, that an angle whose value is more than 180 degree is called reflex angle. This angle is called reflex angle. And value of reflex angle is more than what? More than 180 degree. If theta is more than 180 degree, then such angle is called reflex angle. Then such angle is called reflex angle. So I think that many things I have discussed with you about angles. In next video we are going to discuss few more and interesting thing. So be with me. I am your teacher, guide and a friend, Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi.